This is what we call an anti-groundhog hole. And the reason for that is as follows. We have been trying to film a groundhog, but during that we have literally seen everything else but a groundhog. The story started with Chongor, my smallest son, coming for a walk here and then running back to me and telling that he saw two baby groundhogs that came out to him and very close, and then they ran back into the bush. So we came in here into the bush and searched for the burrow and then found this one. So then we placed this wildlife cam right in front of the burrow, and we didn't put any bait or anything. We just let it go, see what happens. The first thing we saw was not a groundhog at all, it was a chipmunk. The chipmunk was around here and then all around collecting things and then appeared sort of every couple of hours. Another thing we saw was a robin, or maybe many robins, but they fly here. This is more exposed than the rest and they pick worms, and they just love staying in front of the camera. Then one day we saw this gorgeous woodpecker just landing here in front of the camera and looking around and then leaving. Another night I left a couple of carrots here thinking the groundhog will love the carrots, and the carrots were still here for like a day, so there was no activity. But then the second night a raccoon appears, and the raccoon eats the carrot. It even comes very close to the camera. Raccoons are very curious and sniffs at the camera, so I have like a shot of the raccoon this close, but still no groundhog. Then finally something came out of the burrow. One night we see this mouse, tiny mouse, jumping out here, looking around, going around fast and disappearing back. So at least there is an inhabitant of the burrow, but it's this small. We also saw the raccoon trying to go in to the burrow. So it gets in so far that even its tail is inside, and I actually was afraid that it gets stuck. It did not, it somehow reversed back with a carrot which fell in and leaves with a carrot. And then one day, 4 or 5 days after we started this experiment, the groundhog appears from there, not from the hole, from there, stops in front of the camera, stands up with a carrot, chews on the carrot, and then leaves. And then one day later we see the groundhog again finds one of the leftover carrots, and then we see the groundhog going inside the hole. There must be another entrance. We scanned all the area here. It's not easy to find the other entrance, because what I learned is that they conceal the other entrance. They put leaves on it, they put it in the bush. Since then I left these two big pieces of broccoli, because I heard that groundhogs love broccoli. These have been here for like 2 days without any effect. So I think the next will be to try if they like some kind of fruit, maybe peach or pears or apples. I've not decided yet. I'm sure we actually received some emails while we were here. If it worked, yeah. So let me just during this movie or documentary, while I was explaining the broccoli, it took an image of my hand touching the broccoli and sent me an email on my smartphone, which was in my pocket.